recording.
Okay, so we'll go with this quickly. The bubble sort, the insertion sort, and the quick sort. So we have like 4, 3, 4, 2, 3, 1. Yeah. And I wanted to make the bubble sort. How I do it? I will start from here. So I am here. 4 > 2, yes.
Yeah.
So exchange. So this will be 2, this will be 4. I will keep it this, so I am here, right? Mm-hmm. Now, 4 > 3, yes, I reach this point, okay? So I will exchange it, 3 and 4, now I am here. This is the 2, I did not touch it, 1, I did not touch it. Now, 4 > 1, because I reached the 4 now.
Mm-hmm.
4 > 1, yes. So this is will be 1, this is will be 4. And here I reach the last point, right? I did not touch this, right? I reach the last point here. So the last point is what?
4.
That's it, I did not, I am not going to touch it again. So my list start like 4 items. Now I end up with the 3 items and I know the 4th one is sorted. Okay? So, I have to start again, right? So I will start again. And here. So I'll start from 2. So I will say 2 > 3, 2, 3, 1, and this is 4, that's it, it's sorted.
Yes.
So I don't want to touch it. Now I'll start from 2. 2 > 3, no. That's fine, so I am not changing. So 2, 3, 1, and 4, it's already sorted. So I reach this point now, right?
Mm-hmm.
3 > 1, yes, so exchange. So I will put 1 here, I'll put 3 here. So now I am here at this point. I'm not touching 2, I'm not touching 4 because 4 already sorted. So because I reached the last point, I mean this is sorted as well, right? So actually this is now sorted, right? And this is already sorted from here, from the previous one. Clear? So what I have now, I have only 2 items not sorted, right? So I will start again and I will say 2, 1, 3 sorted, 4 sorted. This is sorted, I am not touching this. So I am starting now from this. 2 > 1, yes. So exchange it. So this is 1, this is 2. So now I am here, but I am at the end, right? Because I am checking only this, right? I don't need to check more, right? So I can say, yeah, this is sorted, and this is already sorted, this is already sorted, which is 3 and 4. And as long as I have only 1 number left, so this is also sorted as well. Do you get the idea?
Yeah.
This is the bubble sort. This is what? This is bubble. Bubble sort. Right? Can you take photo for it, please? Okay. Because I will ask you to send it to the group later. You can be close if you want. Okay? So thank you, Hasib, and
Abbasin
for helping in that. Okay. Now I'm going to make the insertion sort. So here I will do what we call the insertion sort and see how it's working, right? Okay, so I will see how 4, 2, 3, 1. 4, 2, 3, 1. 4, 2, 3, 1. how it's going to be insertion sort. So the same question I will ask. Is 4 greater than 2? Yes. So I will say 2 is not on the right position. Okay? So I will say, in this case, 2 is not on the right position because 4 greater than 2, right?
Yes, yeah.
So 2 should come to a position before 4. But where is the before 4? I don't have anything before 4. So I know it's this position is right. Right? So I will put 2 there and I will display anything that before 2 to the right. So I'll put 2 here. And then what I display, only 4, right? So I display 4, I push it, and then 3, and then 1. I did not touch it. I reached this point. Right?
Yeah.
So now I am here. So I am asking, is 4 greater than 3?
It is.
Yes. So when I said yes, mean 3 is not on the right position. So I'm not saying exchange. I said 3 is not on the right position. Do you get the idea?
Yeah, you just
go to the back. So in this case, 3 is not on the right position. So I wanted to search, where is the 3? Where I can insert the 3? That's why it's called insertion sort. So I will check. Is it here?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's it. We found it, right? So what's the meaning? I mean that I'll put 2 here, and then I'll put a 3 here, and I will display any number that I cross it to the right. So this is what before, and this is what I reach, and this is 1. Great? Now, when we are going to check, is 4 greater than 1?
Yes.
Yes. So 4 is not on the right place. So I will go and check for, and sorry, the 1 is not on the right place. So I will go and check 1. And here what I said, 1 is not on the right place. So I wanted to check and see here how it's working. Is it here?
No.
No.
Where at the beginning?
This is the computer. I have to check it one by one. It's not like our mind. We know exactly where it's going, right?
Sure.
So, is it here? No. Is it here?
Yes.
Yes. Do you get the idea? This is the insertion.
Yeah.
I wanted to see, is it here? And then when I compare it, no, it's not here. Let's try another position. Is it here? When compare this to 1, no, it's not here. So it should be?
1.
It should be before. So what I have, I cross like 3 items. So I put 1 in the beginning and display these 3 items to the right. The beauty of insertion sort, when you reach the last line, the last number is sorted. So you see here, I'll put 1 here, and I will display the 2 and the 3 and 4 to the right. So T, 2, 3, and 4, and that's it. It's sorted. I don't need to, like bubble sort, to start again and again. Do you get the idea? So this is very efficient. Now, while we are studying the bubble sort, just for educational needs, because if we understand how the computer or how the pseudocode or how the Python code working with the bubble sort, so we will understand how this is worked later, because this is the algorithm of this. It's not easy to understand. So we need to understand how the bubble sort working, and then we'll understand how this is working in programming. That's why we study the bubble sort for educational need. Don't use bubble sort in your on your program. Use this. This is quicker. It's very quicker because see, when you reach the last point, when you reach the last item, it's sorted. You don't need to come back again from the beginning like bubble sort. So bubble sort need more steps, while here need less steps. And when I check the time for bubble sort and insertion sort, I found in big list, I found the insertion sort is 1,000th time better in time than bubble sort. Almost that. Almost that. Okay? Is it clear? Take a photo for it, please.
Yeah. Do you go to gym?
Gym?
Yeah.
Sometimes. You cannot.
Nah, I'm not gonna snap the wires.
Difficult. Don't worry, we'll put these photos because I will let them send it to me and I will put it there.
Yeah, okay. my phone's dead. So.
Okay, that's fine. Okay, now when we are going and this is the insertion sort, right?
No.
This is the insertion sort. So now let's go and do the 4, 3, 4, 2, 3, 1. The we said 4, 2, 3, 1, and let's do now the quick sort. Okay? Let's do now the quick sort. Okay?
Yeah.
So in a quick sort, what I am going to do, I will choose a number, the first number. When I choose a number, that number is what is sorted. And then I will put all numbers less than that number to the left. And I will put all numbers greater than that number to the right. So you can't choose the first, you can't choose the last, you can't choose any number. But when you choose, when you start, let's say here, I will start choosing the first number. So keep in mind, when you choose the number, that number is sorted. And I will let you know how. So I will choose the first number, which is 4. So if I start with the first number, I have to continue with the first number.
Yeah.
Okay? So I'll choose 4. So I am choosing 4. So now the 4 is what is sorted.
Yeah.
I will see who's less than 4, who's greater than 4. So 2 is less than 4. What the students make things like it's not working. They put like 3 here, they put 1 and they put 2. No, you have to go with the same arrangement because this is computer. This computer cannot see these things. So the computer see the 2 in the beginning. So 2 coming in this basket. Okay? Yes. Let's say this is the basket less, this is the basket bigger. And less or equal. So this is 2. Now 3 less than 4. It's coming in this direction. And then the computer see 1. And the 1, he will put it here. What's the greater than 4? Nothing. There is no number greater than 4. So 4 now is sorted. That's it. I know 4 in the right position. Now I will repeat the same thing. What's the first number in here?
2.
So I will put 2 in here. So when I choose 2, mean this is sorted. Mean 2 in here. And I will see who's less than 2, who's greater than 2. Is that clear?
Mm-hmm.
So, what's the number is 3. 3 less than 2 or greater than 2?
Greater.
So it will come here. And then 1, the computer will see 1. 1 is less than 2 or greater than 2?
Less.
So it will come here. Great? That's it. If you check this now, if you check this, because this is, I have 1 number to the left, so it is sorted already. Because I have only 1 number in here, so it's sorted. If I have more than 1 number, I have to repeat these things. Do you get the idea? So you see numbers now? Sorted or not? This is the quick sort. Do you get the idea? How it's working?
Take photo.
Great. Now we found this. Now we'll go to do the program, the Python thing. How we can do the Python thing? So as I said, we have to start with the bubble sort because it's easy to understand. Okay? So let's see how we can do it. And I am going to put the 4, 2, 3, 1 I am going to put it here so you can compare it easily. So I'll put the 4, 3, 2, 1 in here, right? And I will repeat the bubble sort for it. So I said, is this greater than this? Okay, yes. So this is 3, this is 4, and I know this is happening. So I am reaching this point, right?
Yeah.
This is the bubble sort. Is this greater than this? Yes, so I'm not touching 1 and 3, but I am exchanging this. So this is 2, this is 4. So I know it's going like this, right? And then I'm going, is 4 greater than 1? Yes, so I'm not touching 3, I'm not touching 2. I just exchange this. So this is will go like this. And I know they now, my 4 is what is sorted. Right?
Yeah.
This is the bubble sort. So I have now the smallest list. We call it 3, 2, 1. So I'll start from 3 now. So I will say the 3, 3, 2, 1. I will keep 4 later because I have only this list is not. I will write the rest. So I say I will start here. Is the 3 greater than 2?
Yeah.
Yes. So exchange 2. 3, I will put the 1, I did not touch it, and this is what's happened. So I am reaching this point now, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then, is 3 greater than 1? Yes, so I am not touching the 2, I am touching, I am just exchanging this, and this is the 3 and 1, I reached that point. And this point is what? Is the last point, right?
Mm-hmm.
Last 3, so I know that 3 now is what is sorted. So what's less now? What's left is only 2 and 1. I sorted 4, I sorted 3, so I have only 2 and 1. So I'm going and see the 2 and 1, and I'm saying 2 and 1. So I am here. Is 2 greater than 1?
Yes.
Yes, so exchange it. So this is 1, this is 2. So I am exchange it because I reached the last point, meaning 2 is what? Is the maximum, right? So you see here, you have 4, you have this one. So I will make this here. This is the 4, this is the position of 4. And this is the position of 3. It's the position of 4. So I will go and do the, this is the 3 in here. And this is the, before in here. Why I put it in square? To let you know that I will not touch these square things when I compare it. Okay? So I have now 1, 2, 3, 4. So you can say, oh, we reached the point where the this one as well is sorted. Because I have only one number. I cannot compare it with anything. So I know this is what we call this. This is bubble sort, right? This is bubble sort. So this is bubble. Okay? This is what we did, actually. I wanted to see how I can do it in Python. Here, 4, 3, 2, 1 is a list. Right? It's a list. So I will say, okay, make like G or something. What do you want to name it, the list? Let's name it G, like group of numbers.
Mm-hmm.
Or list, L, like. So I will use the G. So G is equal, what's equal? Equal 4, 3, 2, 1. This is not sorted, right? Please write it.
Program is.
Yeah.
Okay. Equals.
And to see if this is the right one, okay, and then erase it, say print G, and see if this is appeared to you.
So you're welcome.
Right? Sorting, right? But not sorted, right? This is not sorted. Am I right?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
So keep the print G in there for you. And let's do the home. Keep the print G for you, so, but I will erase it from here. Okay? So, I wanted to know that when I have G is equal this, 4, 3, 2, I think 4, 3, 2, 1, or 4, I think 4, let's make this, no problem, because we tried the 4, 2, 3, 1, right? In the beginning, I don't know. Anyway, let's keep it like this, okay? So what's the position of the 4? We said the position of the 4 in the list is 0. You remember that? The position of 3 is 1, because we have to start from 0. The position of 2 is what? 2. The position of 1 is what? It's 3. So if I wanted to get, if you can't try this, if you wanted to get number 3, you have to say print G, and then open this and set 3, like this. Sorry, not 3, 1. The position of 1, because the position of 1. So G of 1 will give you 3, right? So we said print G and give me the index of 1. This is the index of 1. This is, we call it index. The positions of each number. So the position of 4 now in 0 position. The position of 3 in 1 position. The position of 2 in 2 position. The position of 1 in 3 position. Do you get the idea?
Yeah.
Okay. So this is just to give you the imagination, how it works. So when I am going to compare what I did here, see how what I did. I said, is 4 greater than 3? If yes, swap, right? How I can do it in programming? See how I do it. So I will say here, and please focus in here. I will say if I said 4, how I can say 4 in programming? It means G0. Right? So I will say if 4 mean if G 0 greater than,
should I write this?
G, yes. 1. If G 0 greater than G 1 and put the colon.
You mean semicolon?
No, colon. Not semicolon. Okay? And make enter. When you make enter, the pointer will come here on this direction almost. Like 4 spaces. When you make enter, the pointer will come here. Right? Mm-hmm. Like give you like 4 spaces because this is the right thing.
Yeah.
Okay? What I said, if this is greater than this, swap. Swap. What's the meaning of swap? Mean make the G0 equal 3 and make the G1 equal 4 because this is the 0 and this is the 1. How I make it? So easy in Python. You see, I have this G0 and G1, right? So I will say, you see how I make it, the swap thing. I will say G0, comma, should use comma, G, 1 is equal. Equal what? Equal reverse thing. The G, this is will equal G1, comma, G0. So what will go? The G1, the value of G1 will go to the G0. The value of G0 will go to the G1. I swapped. Do you get the idea?
See, yeah.
Okay, now make a print G after, you will get the first step.
So yeah, it basically means if 4 is greater than, I think, 3, which it is,
yeah,
then 4 is...
Well, why,
run? Oh, I didn't run it. No,
okay. Okay, so now print G here in 5, print G.
Yeah.
Print, yeah,
Print G, not
just print. No,
yeah,
just print G.
Yeah. Okay. No, just G. Change or not? Okay, this is also print G in the beginning. Always put like print G after each step so you will know how this happened. Okay? G only, G not zero.
Yeah.
Print G. Come on, copy. Okay. And here, make print G. To see the difference. See?
Yeah.
So put print G in here. Put print G in here. And to see the difference. I will not write it because I don't have space. Is that clear?
Yeah, it's a good visualizer.
Great. Let's continue. And we'll go after print G to go what? Now I reach the one, right? I reach the one, like here, I reach this. I reach the position of one. So I wanted to compare between the one and two position. One and two position. So I will come here and I say, if...
Oh, did we do a for loop?
Later.
Okay.
Because this is how we are constructing the program.
I get it.
Okay. So I will go here and I say, if, another if statement, you put it after print G, okay? If G1 greater than G2, and put the colon, swap. So mean swap, when you make enter, you have to get like space, the indentation, okay? And I will say G1, comma, G2, will equal G2, comma, G1. Okay, great. So I reach this point now. I reach this point now, right? We have like 3, 2, 4, 1, right? This one was... So now I reach the G2. So I will start with the G2 again. So I will say... If, again, from the beginning, if G2 greater than G3, okay, and make the colon, swap. So what's the swap? Here it should be indentation. And I said G2, comma, G3, is equal G3, comma, G2. So when I make this equal and exchange, mean this swapping. You get the idea? Chica?
Yeah.
So now what we reach? We reach this point now. Right?
Yeah.
Right, Hasib?
Yeah.
Do you see how we program things? Okay, now we reach this line. So I have to start from the beginning.
Yeah. So we just copy and paste the same code.
Almost, but let me tell you something. We are not reaching the three because in this case I have only three items. The four I will the position three I will not touch it because it's already assorted. So I will come here and please For you, you just continue down, okay? Because I don't have space in here. So this is just continue in here. Okay, so I'm just continue. So I will say here, I will start again from the beginning. I'll start again from the beginning. So what I will say, if, now what I have only these three, zero and one and two. So I said, if G of 0 greater than G of 1. Start it again, right? Start it again. What? Swap. Swap how? When you make enter, mean G 0, comma G 1 is equal G 1, comma G 0. Is that clear? And then make print G as well. You see, it's the same. Just repeat it. Right?
Mm-hmm.
It's like copy and paste thing. So I'm starting again from here. Starting again. Now I reach this one. I reach the G one, right? So now I am going to make another if statement. And I said if. If. Now this is mean that I reach this point. Now I am reaching this point here. With this. I am reaching this point. Now I am going to do the other if statement. If G1 greater than G2, swap. So I said G2, comma. Sorry, G1, G2, G1, comma, G2 is equal G2, comma, G1. Anything difficult in here?
Same code.
Yeah? And this is the same code. I will use this word, same code, to do something later. So here I am, what I have 0, 1, 2, right?
Yeah.
So I don't need to go with the 3 because I don't need to check the 4. 4 is sorted. No need to make like extra line. Okay, no need for that. So I finish, I reach that point, and here I reaching this point. So when you print, when you run it, you will see this 2, 1, 3, 4, right? Just run it. Do I need to go to 3? This is my question. No, because 4 is sorted already. So I don't need to check it. I don't need to put this. Because my list, now I make it like 3 items. When I said 3 items means 0, 1, 2. I reach the 0, 1, 2. That's it. So I need to start again from the beginning. How I start again? You see here, it's 2, 1, this. So I'll start again. And what I will start, I have only 2 items, means 0 and 1, right? So I have only repeat this one. So I will say if G of 0, again, greater than G of 1. Okay, enter. So you have this space, okay? Swap. Swap mean what? Mean G of 0, comma, G of 1 is equal G of 1, comma, G of 0. You see, I'm this one. Same code.
Yeah. You can still copy and paste and get the same.
Exactly.
So I go right, 1, 2, 3, 4.
You see?
Yeah.
So when you make this one, you will get this one, which is
4, 3, 2, 1.
Yeah.
It's sorted 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? At the end. Right?
Yes.
Abbas?
Yep.
4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. Right?
Yep.
Now let's think about this code. Now I did this code exactly like what we got, and this is what we call the bubble sort. And as you see here, I started with the with 4 items. I started from 0 to 3. 0, 1, 2, 3. 4 items. And then When I have the four, like sorted the last item, I don't need to make like four items. I need only three items. Three items mean what? Man, 0, 1, 2. And you see, I start with 0, end it with 2. Right? The third time when I'm coming to the, you know, from the beginning, I have now two items. Two items mean what? Mean 0 and 1. And this is the 0 and 1. So I don't need to check and again and again. And when I put a print after each one, you can see that you have these numbers exactly, right? Now this is the programmers. Now, if you give this program to any programmer and said, oh, this is stupid. Why you are doing this? Why you are making this? So please pay attention here. This is very important to understand how we are doing this. So you see here, it's 0, 1, and then 1 and 2, and then 2 and 3. So why not you are using, let's say, I and I plus 1. And make I start from 0 to 3, to 2, let's say. So in this case, what you will get, you don't need to repeat this. You just make like for loop.
Yeah.
Okay. So now I will develop that one. And please, don't erase the one that you did it. Now I'm going to change this. And change this. And change this. And keep in mind how I am changing. Okay. So I'll put it on the black. So you will know how I do it. So if I said I is equal 0 as I started, I'll put it here. If I equal 0, so the next one will be what? Will be I plus 1. So I will not make it I plus 1. I will make it J. I will make it J. And J always I plus 1. So if I 0, J will be 1. Right? If I 1, J will be 2. If I 2, J will be
3.
So I need I from 0 to 2. When I said, and you can print this as a code at the end. You can say, if you tried, because I will erase it later, okay? But you can put it. If you said for I in range 3, and put the colon and make the enter, and here said print I, colon, and enter, and they said print I. What you will get?
Number sequence.
Which is the number?
0, 1, 2.
0, 1, 2. So yes, I can use this. See here, I'm not saying don't change anything on your code. For I in range 3, and then colon, and then it's coming like indentation, and I said the print I, it will print 0, 1, 2. So I perform this one. Now here, put it in between, okay? Put this, I will erase this. And put here the same thing, and I said, put it, J is equal I plus 1. And then put here, okay, the same line, the same indentation, print I comma J, and see the result.
See.
I comma J. So what you will get? You will get 0, 1, right? Sorry, that means. This is J is equal I plus 1. So if I 0, this is 1. If I 1, this is 2. If I 2, this is 3. Right? So you'll get 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, right? So what you have now? You have 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, right?
Yeah.
Just imagine. I just wanted to compare between this and compare between them. What you have here? 0, 1.
Yeah.
1, 2, 2, 3. Oh, this is nice. I can use this idea to do these things. Now, how I got I equal 2 and J is equal 3 in this case, what's the relation between I and the length of the G? How many members I have in G?
3.
How many members?
Members?
Members. This is each one called member. One,
oh,
two,
four.
Four members. Right? And what I said here, 4i in range what? 3, right?
Yeah.
3 is 4 minus 1. Right?
So in a minus by...
So I can say this is... You see how I change it now. See how I develop the program. I will say this is only this one. Write it like this. Len, L-E-N, G, minus 1, between brackets. Because len G is 4. So the 3, remove the 3 and put len G minus 1. So why I use len G minus 1 instead of 3? Because here I can use any numbers of not only 4.
Why we use len 3? What's len mean?
Len means length.
Length?
Yeah. Length, yeah. So like 4 letters here, right?
This so length will be... Len, in general, it's counted the members, the number of members of the group. Okay? So how many members you have here? 4. Okay? Now why we are not saying numbers? Because these members can be text, can be anything.
Yeah.
Okay? So we said members. Okay. So from here, what I have the I, which is 4i in range 3. So I said remove 3 and put len g and minus 1 because this will be more general. Okay? Now when I make this, I got this 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 1. So I will change this one, okay, and make it, and how I make it. And please pay attention and check if you can be with them, please, when I change this.
Yeah, okay, I just have to do this though.
So what I will go now, what I have here, G1, it's the same thing. I am saying G, so I will choose, and don't change it now. Make it later, I mean, make it on the, so, what I want you to write, you write G is equal 4321.
Yeah, yeah.
Great. Okay, it's good.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so make the new line and make G is equal 4321. So you can compare how we change it. Don't erase anything, okay? Please follow my instruction exactly, chicken. Be there, because this is the crucial point. So I will put here I will put here J.
Yeah.
But I will put this 4 with these things. So I will not see here what I am going to do. So, for this one here, what I will do, what I will make this. 4, this is G, I will make this 4,
new line, I guess.
4 I in range len G minus 1.
Another bracket. G. And outside that bracket.
Minus 1.
Yes,
sir. Okay? When I make enter, it should give me the indentation in here. Okay?
Yeah.
And then what I will say?
It's a len. Yeah.
I will say here, if G of I, oh, sorry. So Sorry for that. It's my bad. Oh. I will say here, J is equal I plus 1. Exactly like what we did in here. And make enter. You see this one? It's just to make the, and I will make here, and I said, if G I greater than G of J, and put the colon and make enter. When you make enter, you have to get this one.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes. Yeah.
Like two spaces. Yeah. Now swap. Okay? So I will swap here, and I said G I comma G J is equal G J comma G I. If we make it smaller, G G I,
yes, minus,
comma,
I mean
G J,
backspace,
equal,
space.
G okay. J,
G,
comma,
G
I.
Yeah. Comma. No. Yeah, comma.
Great. Hasib?
Yeah.
And make enter.
Enter.
And make here print. Make here when you are cut. You have to come back and make print J here. Print G, sorry, not J.
Print G.
Print G, but it's in the beginning of the line.
Yeah.
It's all good.
Okay?
No.
Run it.
In 3, 2, 1, 4.
3, 2, 1, 4.
3, 2, 1, 4. So I did until here. 3, 2, 1, 4. When I'm doing this. If I repeat this one, see, and keep in mind. If I repeat this one again, but I will say that this is should be minus 2. So I will remove this and I'll put minus 2. Why? Because this is starting from 0, 1, and 1, 2. Right? So, it's look like, let's make it again. So after, so I will do this here for the second line. So I will repeat this the same thing. But here, what I am doing 4. Do it with me, please. You can copy and paste.
What's this about? Sorry.
In range, len G minus 2 now. This is the next line. Starting again. But this is minus 2. Okay? And then said J is equal I plus 1. And then said if G of I greater than G of J then go here and put the G of I G of J equal G of J G of I. Sorry. Anyway, we'll make it again. Okay? And now said print, and now print G. So you see here, you are using the same code. You see the same code?
Mm-hmm.
Well, this is only the things. So copy and paste. You will get this one, the second line.
2, 1, 3, 4.
Now you wanted to go to the last line? Okay, we'll repeat it again. So I will say, for I, in range, lin of G, but this time minus a 3. Yeah, copy and paste. Okay. J is equal I plus 1. And then here, you can say if G of I greater than G of J, swap. Swap mean G of I, oh sorry, I have to make it in red one so you will see the pattern. G of I, comma, G of J is equal G of J, comma, G of I. Okay? Do you get it?
Yeah.
And then said print. Oh, where is the if statement? Oh. It's my bad. I have to check the if statement first. Said if G of I greater than G of J, so make the G of I, this is the G of I, comma, G of J, is equal G of J, comma, G of I. And then you can go and set print G. And you are reaching the last point. Right? Just copy and paste. Now compare between this and this and this. What's the difference?
Minus 1.
Yeah? Minus 2.
Minus 2, minus 3.
Right? Oh, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Keep in mind, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So if I make a k, a variable called k, like this, and they said 1, 2, 3. So that means I can start from, I can make like for loop for k, and start from 1, and to 4, because 4 is not taken. So it will take like 1, 2, 3. Without repeat this, because this is pattern repeating. The only difference is this. The only difference is this. Am I right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I can make, so why not making the K in there and display the all things to the right by using tab. And see how I am doing. Now, when I said 4, 1, 2, 3, that means that I can do the K, and I will write it here, but I will erase it, okay? I can say that 4, K, in range.
New line.
In range, 1 to what? We said to 4. For what? Compare here, for what? What we said about this four?
It's
the length of the list. Right? Four is the length of the rest or not?
It is.
That's it. We found it. Do you get the idea?
Yeah.
So I can say, started from one to the length of the list, which is four. So the K will take the one and two and three. It will not take four. Because why? Because, and then I can put the K in here, and K in here. Right? So that's it. So I don't need to repeat this because you see here, what you did actually in your code, you just copy and paste, copy and paste, copy and paste. The copy and paste means this is the iteration, means this is another loop. So I will go here and I said, this should be to the len of G. That's it. So I said, okay, I will go here and do it and do it and see how it works. I will say here four. From the beginning here, so I have to display all of this. Don't do anything now, and Jacob, please will help them later, not now.
X.
Four, I will say 4K.
Yes. Where should we do this? Like what line?
You can make like a new line and okay, then copy and paste later. Good. But the, keep mind here. Keep your eyes here. Don't write anything on your screen. So see how I am doing this.
Yeah.
Okay, 4K. In range 1, because I have to start with the 1, okay, 2, len of G, and put the colon. Now when you make enter, you have to start here. So here, this is the indentation. You have to put the, you have to copy this as it is, but use the tab for each one. So put the tab here and press it. And you see this, the indentation here? You have to add this indentation. Okay? And you have to add this indentation. The same one. Here, what you put here, don't put one, put what? Put K, minus K. Now please, copy this code and send it to the send it to the group. You know our group.
I'm gonna do it now.
What, just
you can do it now, right?
Well, like this, I've put a notepad, it's not like long.
Yeah.
You know I mean,
copy
my code.
But save it as text, okay? And put it on the.
Is it the affair the gang?
Yeah. Put it on the group. Do you have a question now?
Yes,
now you see this is no more for this. Now what I want from you, now remove all the code before, just keep it from here for K and this, like G is equal this, and remove all the code before.
Okay.
Just let me.
Why?
So bring this. Or keep this G and remove all of this. Okay, run it.
So with this.
You see how the code is small now?
Mm. Well, like this.
Yeah? So I want the old code and the new code because this is the progress how we are doing this.
Oh, you want it in separate, like?
Yeah.
Notepads, okay. Fine.
I mean, I want the code whole until we reach that point. And then when you remove the code before, and you get this, okay?
I think I'm done.
Okay. Now what I want from you, put 20 numbers in here and see the result. So you can, this is here. It's to see each line, you need to go here, and this is put print G. So you can see every line. But if you wanted to see only the last one, just put here in the beginning, okay? In the beginning, said print G, and remove that one. So you will get only the last item.
Okay.
And we'll remove this one. Remove it and put only this. So you will get only the final result.
We only just get the final. Okay, I see how that works.
So you see how we started. We started in details.
Yeah.
Like the manual things. And I said, oh, this is, I can make this I and make J. Where J, because I always compared the 0 with 1, 1 with 2, 2 with 3, 3 with 4, 4 with 5. So why should I make this? So I can make like I and I plus 1. Which I name it as Z, right? Sorry, I name it as J, right? So compared between I and J, where the J is I plus 1. That's it. You get the idea?
Yeah.
And then what we found, that when we make the for loops, the first for loop for the first line, the second for loop for the next line, right? The third for loop for the third line, I said, oh, this is the same for loop. The only one is change is this. So I start with minus one, and then minus two, and then minus three. And I said, okay, let me make another loop called K. And K will take the 1, 2, 3 to the length of the list minus one. So we did it in here. Because here, if the length of list is 4, mean K will take what? Will take 1, will take 2, will take 3, but 4 will not take it because it's exclusive. So here I am saying from 1 to 4, 4 is not included in my account. Do you get the idea?
Yeah.
And yeah. And then when I try it with the many numbers as I want, you can put like 1,000 numbers in here. And it will be sorted. So we learn?
Yeah, that was pretty good. I liked learning that.
Great. Great. So if you can take photo, please. For this, Mr. Hasib,
I have it all on my.
Here I should take the values of
2, 3, 4, right?
Yeah, length of I minus length of J minus.
Is it this picture? This one? This one here?
Yeah. This. All of this. Take it.
Yeah,
thank you.
Sir.
Yes.
Coding is making me